Hello everyone, it's good to be with you again today. Today we are going to continue our lessons on the life and ministry of Jesus, and we're going to learn about a story that Jesus told the people. But first, let's sing together.
Oh,
Last week, our memory verse was Matthew 14, verse 16. Jesus replied, "They did not need to go away. You give them something to eat." This week, our memory verse is Matthew 13, verse 23. Seed falling and good soil refers to someone who heard the word and understands it. Please say it with me. Matthew 13, verse 23. Seed falling on good soil refers to someone who heard the word and understands it. Let's sing another song.
The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Thank you, Lord, for making me. Oh, let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord.
The bears in the woods say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
The bears in the woods say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
The bears in the woods say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for making me.
Oh, let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord.
The gators in the swamp say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Chomp, chomp, chomp. The gators in the swamp say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Chomp, chomp, chomp. The gators in the swamp say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Chomp, chomp, chomp. Thank you, Lord, for making me.
Oh, let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord.
Today, I want to talk to you about a plant. Did you know that a plant can grow from a seed? What do we need to do with the seed to get it to grow a plant? Well, we have to plant the seeds. You're right. But for planting the seed, we need to make sure that we have the right soil, the right pot, a place to put it, and some water. And then we need to wait, because it takes time for it to grow. When Jesus was on earth, he often told stories to people. He told them the stories to help them understand the word better. Today, we are going to hear one of those stories, or a parable as it was called in the Bible. Today's parable is called the parable of the sower. It was a story about a man who planted seeds in the field. We read about this in Matthew 13, verse 1 to 9 and 18 to 23. Please watch this video with me to see what happened.
Stories of the Bible. The parable of the farmer. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, Jesus went and sat beside the sea. A great crowd gathered around him.
Oh, hey, everyone.
So he got in a boat and told them many things in parables.
Okay, listen to this.
He told them this story. A farmer went out to plant some seed. As he scattered it across his field, some of the seed fell on a footpath where it was stepped on, and the birds came and ate it. Other seed fell on shallow soil among rocks. The seed began to grow quickly because the soil was shallow, but the plant soon wilted under the hot sun, and since it didn't have deep roots, it died. Other seed fell among thorns that grew up and choked out the tender plants. Still, other seed fell on fertile soil. This seed grew and produced a crop that was 100 times as much as had been planted. When Jesus had said this, he called out, "Anyone with ears to hear should listen and understand."
Yeah?
Later, the disciples came to Jesus and asked what this parable meant. Jesus said, "The farmer plants seed by taking God's word to others. The seed that fell on the footpath represents those who hear the message, only to have Satan come at once and take it away. The seed on the rocky soil represents those who hear the message and immediately receive it with joy. But since they don't have deep roots, they don't last long. They fall away as soon as they have problems or are treated badly for believing God's word. The seed that fell among the thorns represents others who hear God's word, but all too quickly the message is crowded out by the worries of this life and the desire for other things. And the seed that fell on good soil represents those who hear and accept God's word and produce a harvest of 30, 60, or even 100 times as much as had been planted."
Our Sunday school teacher or our pastor is trying to plant the teaching of God's love in our hearts. It is like planting a seed. If our heart is hard and filled with anger and bitterness, the teaching fails and it's what's like falling on hard ground and never grows, just like the seed that fell on the hard ground in the parable that Jesus told. There are other times when we hear the word and we get excited about it, but then our excitement fades away a little bit because we understand it too shallow. That's the way it was when the seed fell on the rocky soil. Sometimes we hear the word and we believe what it says, but we keep on going the same way we were before. That is like the planting of the seed in the bunch of weeds. I'm sure you can guess what happens. The weeds soon take over, and there's no space for the plants to grow. The last seed is the best. It fell on the good ground. If you learn what you hear in the Sunday school and at church, that seed that Jesus plants in your heart will grow. Your life will produce good fruits, and it would be just like Jesus intended. You will help others to grow in the knowledge and understanding of God's love as well. Let us pray. Our Father, help us to be like the good soil in our lesson today. Help us to listen to your word and grow up to be a kind boy or girl. Help us to be the way you made us to be and the way you want us to be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We're going to close this lesson with one more song, so please sing with me.
Heart. Do not give up. Pray and
And now you can do the activities that go with this lesson. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you all next week. Bye.